Hi!
Hello!
In this episode, we are going to talk about how we prepared supports on the top of our shipping container to hold a wooden deck.
Let's get to it!
We actually have two reasons for building these supports. The first one is to elevate the level of the
wooden deck
so we can have a roof underneath the deck between the shipping container and the deck.
The second reason for us to build these supports was money. The thing is, before we had a support every 6 meters, the main beam of this deck would be supported here and 6 meters later. That means the section of the beam that we need to use would be, I don't know, something like 15 centimeters by 30 centimeters or something like that. And when we added two supports in between, now we have a support every 2 meters. That means we went down to 6 centimeters by 12 centimeters. And the price went down from maybe 1.5 times the price of the shipping container itself. That means all the wood for the deck would cost like the price of 1.5 shipping container. And now we are like half of the price of one shipping container, so that's pretty good.
Yeah, so now let's get to the process of building these supports.
Well, the first step, just to make sure we have all the supports leveled on the same level. You know, this shipping container is supposed to be all on the same level, but that's not reality. In the reality, sometimes one side is like 2 centimeters lower than the other side and this and that, so we try to fix these small mistakes on the support. So the first step was to get a water leveler and try to draw a layout showing each support and how high the support needed to be. So that means like one support would be like 5 centimeters, the other one could be 6, the other one could be 4, all depending on where it's located, the support.
So one of them we called 0, and we put some numbers for each one.
Yeah, the process was choosing the highest one and deciding that that one was 0, and then we just say how many centimeters we need to get to 0. So that means, you know, plus 7 centimeters, plus 6 centimeters, plus 3 centimeters. We draw the layout, and then
we got some steel that we had left.
We always try to use what we have instead of buying new things, because you know, when you buy material, there is always leftovers. So we decided to do all the supports with the leftovers from the windows.
Yeah, so we got that and we cut some pieces. We decided that each support would be 15 centimeters.
It's enough.
Yeah. So we cut, I don't know.
The first step was just to cut the metal bar into pieces and try to cut them in the right height, because we wanted to have a support that's a little bit the width, like how to say,
wide
of the support is a little bit smaller than the beam itself. So the beam is 6 centimeters and the support is 5 centimeters, and the reason for that is because if there is water, the water can drip instead of accumulating in between the support and the wood, so the wood will get bad with time.
So the steel was like what's the measure of the steel?
Was 15 centimeters by
3 4 3.
Oh yeah, so the steel tubing we used was 5 centimeters by 3 centimeters. That means most of the middle supports were more than 3 centimeters. That means we need to have one tube plus something else.
Yeah.
So we cut one tube. We always use 15 centimeters tube, so we have like a 15 centimeters support. Yeah. And then we cut the bottom in different heights depending on where we are. I think
we can show it.
Yeah, it's just too much talking. There is not much to talk about. So now let's show you guys a clip of how we cut the metals, how we weld them together, and how we weld them on place, and how we painted, because we need to treat, otherwise it's gonna get rusted.
Yeah.
So. And just to make sure you understand, we painted this time with a primer that is
the green one
that's called zinc chromate primer. The reason for that is because we you know, we had a can and we need to use it. So, and what, that's just like a small job, so we just decide to use this primer. And after that, we paint with the same color, the same kind of paint we painted the whole roof.
The liquid asphalt.
Yeah, the liquid asphalt, the same paint we use for the roof of the shipping container. It's like a rubbery paint.
And now it's done. We just need to create the deck.
Yeah, but now let's show you guys how we did the whole process. So, video clip, right? Now.
A little bit up.
So the idea now is to weld these two together, like this, so we can support the deck and we can screw the deck on the support. So if we do this, we can have like a support every 2 meters, and this will help to get like a much smaller dimension and less money. Let's get the weld machine, let's get going.
How's the web?
Pretty good.
Can you show us?
Yeah.
Yeah. I hope it was possible to understand what we did, what he did. So, was that easy?
Well, actually it was pretty easy, but I don't know if it's right yet. What I mean by that, first, welding the support itself was really easy. The weld that need to be strong, that's basically the weld in between the top part and the bottom part, was perfect, easy, straightforward. The only tricky part was that we used tubes, so the side of the tube was open, and I don't want to leave open so the water goes inside. So I need to do the closing on both sides, and the shape is just a weird shape. So that was pretty tricky and was not the best weld ever, but that's not structural. That's basically just to close the sides, so it's fine.
I guess the other hard part was to do the level correct.
Ooh,
the
that was pretty tricky, yeah, because when I put the support on the shipping container, it's not always like, you know, like flat straight. So I need to get a leveler and just try to, you know, get like both angle, both axes right.
That was not easy.
That was pretty tricky, but I mean, the big question is the support right? Are they aligned perfectly? We don't know yet. The thing is, we need to have the wood and put the wood on place, the beam on place, and then we will know if it's 100% right. And that we will find out this week, because we didn't do the wood part yet.
So, I hope this week we finally can build the wooden deck.
Yeah, we still need to paint all the woods before we assemble the deck together. So hopefully this week we'll be able to give 3 coats of painting on every wood of the deck. And then we are able to assemble the deck together for next Monday. Hopefully we'll have an episode about the assembling of the deck.
If you like this video, just give a like.
Yeah, sometimes seems like cliche to ask you guys for likes, but the truth is, the like helps a lot. Doesn't matter how well we try to edit a video, if people won't find the video, doesn't matter, you know, like, the video doesn't matter if the video is good if no one watches. And if you give a like, that means that Mr. U2, you know, the computer behind of the system, will know that people are actually watching and are actually liking the video, so they are gonna suggest this video for more people. And the more YouTube suggests our video, the more people finds the project, and I, you know, it's just like a snowball. Things work, and we're working really hard for that, so if you guys can help and give us a thumbs up. And
if you have any comments or suggestions, just comment below.
If you think the support is just terrible, let us know. If you think it's pretty cool, let us know also. And if you have any other suggestion or idea, not, you know,
from a future project as well.
Of something related to our shipping container, just let us know. We are glad to read and to answer and to try to, you know, use the ideas.
Yeah. So I guess I see you guys next week.
See you guys next week.
Well, we actually have an airplane.
Them airplanes. I don't know, they never pass here, but whenever we start recording, there's always an airplane. So we can wait a little bit.